let's play a game. Pick up any name. Then count the blames which people have for that name. Oh, is it a matter of shame if a corpse is not buried but burnt in flames? No, no, let's debate because it's our favorite game. So what's wrong if I'm just Durgesh or Suman? Does it make me any less human? What if I'm born from a mother who follows Islam? Does it sound violent to you if I greet you with a salam? It's not even us who decides our own religion. Did God spoke through his heavenly pigeons? I was just a zygote when my religion was decided. So why should we forget that it wasn't me who bided? So what's wrong if I'm just Faisal or Abdullah? Doesn't it mean same if I say Shiv or Allah? Maybe there is some God. Maybe it's true. But why to divide God in different crew? Moksh, heaven or Jannat? No hatred will help you in Akhirat. Whatever comes after the judgment day, you have to do karma, virtues and neki every day. Why it is so tough to understand mosque, church or temples? Doesn't matter where you stand. What's in your heart matters the most. Nothing else is required to boast. Supreme reality can be of any ethnicity. Why ignoring that? It also created humanity. So why to let down our dear lords? Hatred misguides us to Rakshas, Iblis or Satan's word. We became whatever our parents told us. So let's hold and think for a while without any ruckus. Together, we can change the entire picture by not just reading but understanding our holy scripture. If I am Rudra, I will go for the Veda. If I am Farhan, understanding the Holy Quran. If Peter is my title, now the book is called as the Holy Bible, and there are many more which may define who am I. But there is always one holy book, which never lie. So if we read, then there is no need. No need to hate, fight, attack or bully. I wish for the day when humanity will be restored fully. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.